Hello, this is Sean Blair for ESA Web TV, and I'm here in ESTEC's Cobalt 60 radiation testing facility. Space is a really hard place to design for. Not only is it a weightless hard vacuum, it's also radioactive. Charged particles out of the sun and out of deep space can do serious damage to unshielded spacecraft components, which is why everything that goes to space gets tested here. So we thought, let's go see how it works.
What happens if we try it out on ordinary smartphones instead?
So we'll go see what they see when we put them in the path of the radiation beam. This ISO-certified facility replicates the lifetime effects of radiation dosages with accelerated testing that simulate years of exposure in a few days. This facility is used to test space components. What will happen when we put a standard iPhone inside? We'll keep the camera running to see how gamma rays affect its view. The walls of the facility are 70 centimeters thick and double that at the very back. Once the 700 kilogram safety door is closed, the Cobalt 60 source rises into position from above its lead shielding and the test begins. In this case, we're just testing for about 30 seconds.
This exposure time was too short to have any permanent effects, but the evidence of gamma ray exposure is there in the phone's video footage. The array of pixels making up the camera turn light into electronic impulses, except in this case, it's the high energy gamma ray photons triggering the camera pixels. It starts as the bolt of Cobalt 60 metal slides up out of its protective shielding. And we turn off the light to increase the effects. You can see that different phones actually have different radiation sensitivity. The elderly webcam we also tried out shows the most snow on screen.
I'm here now with space environment engineer Greg Dupree. So Greg, ESA provides radiation testing facilities. Does ESA also provide training for designing for radiation?
Well, of course, for components engineer here at ESTEC, there's like trainings every year. This radiation course we do every year, but sometimes, as ESA usually organizes a lot of conferences and workshops with external engineers and students and schools, there is this goal organized this year, SERESSA, which is about the effects of radiations in space.
So what will you be doing for that?
Pretty much here, I'm the organizer of the conference, so it's just about gathering all these experts from all around the world, from South America, North America, Asia, together to show and explain to European students and ESA engineers and engineers from all around the world, NASA and other labs, what happens when you put electronic components in space.
The SERESSA workshop is on from the 12th to the 16th of November. This is Sean Blair for ESA Web TV, signing off.